Hello, we are going to see today how to develop a program in C Sharp with Visual Studio 2019. And I will use TDD methodology for test-driven development. For this purpose, I have selected a subject of interest for me. I have here a folder with the different photos coming from my smartphone that I have downloaded. The camera directory here has a lot of images. You see at the bottom there is 1000 images, and they are all in the same subdirectory. What I want is to order all these pictures in subdirectories containing the by months. So here, if we look at the file name, we have three letters, IMG underscore, then the date 2020, then the month 06 for June, then the day. What I want for this specific picture is that it goes inside the month of June of the year 2020. And I want to do this for manually, for manually. I want to do this for one specific subfolder. So if this subfolder, so here you see 1400 items, it will be run again. And same thing for the video. Here you see some video, vid underscore 2018 March 30. So in this case, I want the video to go to the month of March 2018. What is important here, I do not want to focus on the speed of writing the code, but rather on the project organization, how to order the projects between themselves, how to create from scratch a new software. So the first thing that I have already started to do is to create a requirement. So I want to order one target directory at a time. So the input of the program will be only one directory. And so here I have different four or five directories. I can run this program four or five times. This is not a problem. If the directory is already ordered, then I will do not do anything. I will not resorter anything or do any work. All the files to be ordered in next level. By this requirement, I mean that when I go to, if I want to classify this directory video, all the files which must be ordered must be directly inside the video folder. Like camera, for example. Everything is directly here. This is what I mean for this. Each file contains a series of eight letters indicating year, month, day. This is when I write this. This is I specify the input type. I do not want to something to be generic. I have a specific problem, and except some very rare cases like this one. All the file name are a name with three letter underscore then the date. Here is a little exception, but if I want to come to any picture, this is the same thing. Picture here is three letter underscore the date. So each file must contain a series of eight letters, so four letters for the year, two letters for the month and two letters for the day. Each file must be moved to the subfolder named year 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 dash month month. Okay. So this is the main requirement, and we will see how to program the code to do this. I'm working with Visual Studio 2019. I am Thierry Bremer, if you do not know me, and I am a software engineer. In GFK in Germany, and I'm doing this for the fun today. And also because I need it, I want to classify my picture. If you didn't backup your picture from your smartphone, do it now because a smartphone can be lost. On me, I'm doing it proactively without having lost my smartphone, and I do not have any backup on the cloud. So let's start. So I have created already another video with what I call a solution template. So I will first download the solution template. The solution template is the minimum of Visual Studio, which has a project core and a core unit test. So the root architecture with a very low logic is already done. I'm going to download this zip file, save it, and if you want it, you can go on GitHub, Tevremar solution template. This is a public repository, and this can help you to create a project from scratch with some unit test NuGet package, which is already installed. Then I have my zip files. I will go to my program directory. I want to create a new folder for my solution. And I want to order my files. And I like to prefix with the X. So I would say XORDER by month, like this. So the project will be called XORDER by month. I'm pasting my zip files. I'm extracting here what I want, solution master, like this. I'm going to select all these files. I put it in the root of my solution. I delete the files which are not needed here. Okay. So I have my solution template here that I can start. Before starting it, I will create a new repo. Create a new repository like this. Create. Okay, the repository is initialized. I'm going to create the first commit. Yes, I want to commit all these files to start. Init, commit on push. Oh, and then he will say I cannot push it. Yes, because for the starting, I must create a remote repository. So let's do it. So my GitHub file is there. And I'm going to create a new repository here, new repository. The repository name will be named with the name of my project, which is XORDER by month. That I will leave public if you want it. There is no specific private data, so you can use it if you want. XORDER by month. Ok, create a repository like this. Ok, so the XORDER by month. I can take this. Then here I will say XORDER by month. URL is this. And I save the change. Yes. XORDER by month is saved. OK. And I push. Yes. Good. And now, if I refresh my page. OK. So I have started my project. And if I go on it and I open the solution. I am going to put it in the correct screen because I have two screens. Ok, good. Build, rebuild. Then I can go to test, run all tests. Build succeeded, test explorer. Here I have my unit test, and my unit test is there. Ok. And if I double click on it. I have here my unit test. So here how the project is organized. If I look at this file, it is in the core unit test project, which is referencing the core project, which is their class core. Okay? So this is a solution template that I've created, and it's easy to start with this because all the boring job like creating unit test project, adding project dependencies already done. Okay, so I can start with this class core test, and I will patch it so that I will work on the first requirement. So in TDD we work on requirements, then we design the test, and then we write the target code at the end. This is the methodology. So, what can be programmed? Order one target directory. So this is implicit. I cannot do any code on this. If already ordered, do not do anything. For the moment, I do not have any clue how to program this. All files to be ordered are in next level. Okay. Each file contains a series of 8 letters indicating year, month, day. So this is interesting. In fact, what I can do is I say, so I have also a snippet template to write unit tests, you will see. So here, each file contains a series of 8 letters indicating year, month, day. What is the ID of any test that we can think of? We can say that for a given valid file name, for a given valid file name, I must extract the date time, and I will only focus on the file name. I could try to do things with attributes of the file, but I do not want to do this. I want to only my system is only on the file names, even if the file name can be different than the attributes, etc. It is not of importance. What I want, the role is file name. So I will say for a given valid file name, I should extract the date time, the valid date time. Okay. So let's do this. So, if I want to extract the date time, I can say in the design that I will have a method which is called getDate, which has as an input a file name. Okay, so this is my here I'm creating a prototype. And I will say it will return a date time. Okay. So, okay. So let's do this. So I want to have a method which is called getDate. And the method which is called getDate is a method of a target class. And by convention, the target class is in the test called SUT for system under test. So I have a snippet which can be invoked by UT for unit test, tab tab. Then I paste what I have in my clipboard, get date, I enter. And here I have already the code of the unit test which is started. So get date. I will say here I will put as input the file name. So this is string file name. I want a valid file name, so I will put I do not start to sync to any special test cases. I will go directly to a valid file name. I will take a random one, like for example this one, like this, and I'm going to pass the file name. String file name, I input it to my system. File name, and I want that the expected is not a string. So a string is written here because this is a template, but this is now dead time in my context. Expected, and now I can create dead time dot create. It exists or not? No, so I should create a new dead time. New dead time. On here for this example, I want the 2020, comma 02, comma 01. Good. So this is what I expect. And I compare what is expected to what is actually returned by my target method. Visual Studio indicates in red that my target method does not exist. This is normal. I'm constructing the system. I have created the test, and I am going to create the target code. This is TDD, test driven development. Now I'm going to tap Alt Enter. I will generate the method. I go to the definition, and then I can type F12 to go to the definition of the date, which is already now in the target class core class. So the getDate method is there. It must return date time, and I can say that my date time is called red, and then I have another snippet to return the red. It is called red, like this. And I should now here to allocate the time, and let's say for example now I am going to say I have this dead time. I will make like a school demonstration. So I am going to hard code the targeted value 2020. So in fact, this is this what I want. What I want is this. So I put it there. Like this, and I can rebuild everything and check that the first test should be successful. I go to the test explorer and I'm going to say I want to test this. Okay, my test is successful. I am thinking the ideal way to do this is to create a test case with different type of inputs. The problem is that I am not sure that the dead time can be inserted in a test case. I will try it. So, of course, it works now because I have hard-coded in the target method what should be returned. But if I want to do this on different input, I can say this is not anymore a test but a test case, which attribute gives the possibility to enter different inputs. I would just try. I'm not sure if the dead time can be inserted in the test case because there is some condition on the input of test case attribute. Can I do this? I am not sure. New dead time. I am not sure. Yes, he doesn't want initialize in instant. An attribute argument must be a constant expression. So what I can say is in this case I will write the input of the dead time parameter like this. And I will say generate method. And I will revert, in fact. I will put first the expected to be conform like r equal. R equal always has first parameter the expected. So here I have as expected my date, and then I give the input. And here I can patch it to say I give you in parameter int year. Int month, int day, then string file name. But I do not get any more from here. I put it there. On here, I put in the input my year, my month, my day. Good. So so let's try it again. This thing, get date, and it is still working. So this is good because this means that now I have refactored my test so that I will just delete this thing, which is not anymore useful. So now my test is a test case. So I can put different inputs. So what I can do is, for example, I duplicate this line. I will run it again, and you see that maybe it's so much clever that you understand this is rebuild. This is the same test case. Maybe you understand that it's the same input, so it doesn't display different things. So let's say I'm going to take this file. I will take this image randomly like this, and I will put it there. So here in this case, this is 2020-04-08-04-08. Then I'm going to some video and I will take this one like this. And I'm going to say I want this one. So this is 2017-12-19, and let's say I'm going to take another picture or a movie here. Let's say this one, and I will pass it here. So here what I am doing is I am giving some valid input to check that the correct output is obtained. So 2021-12-08. So 2021-12-08. Good. And I do not understand why. Build, rebuild, test explorer. Okay, now we see four different test cases. He says, I am already green for this input, but here you see this exclamation point. This means this is not yet been run. So I'm going to select, and of course it will fail because the target code is only doing the correct job only for one image. So this is the way TDD, the TDD philosophy. We are building progressively the target code. So on here, if we look at the message, output message, expected 2017 1219 for this input, and it was incorrect date, of course. So let's implement the correct thing. And what we are doing, I want to extract a subpart of the string. So I want a substring. Let's say I want string sub string, which is equal to file name dot sub string. And here, I want the start index to be, it is, let's say, 4, and the length, it is 8 bytes, 8 characters, so 8, like this. So here I have a substring. So here I should have, in fact, this part, so 0, 1, 2, 3, 4. I should start at 4, I think it should be good. Then, if this is everything, I can work like this. I can work like this. With this substring, I will just first isolate the date. So let's say string date is equal to sub string dot sub string, this is beginning 4, then string months is equal to sub string dot sub string, it which should start at 5, then 2 of length, then string day is equal to sub string dot sub string. Six four two. I do not take too much time to try to see if the indexes are correct because I will just use a debugger to see if everything is good. So I put the debugger now, and I'm going to debug this test. And to look dynamically if what I want is what is there. So file name, I will put here my file name, or I can look at the locals. Yes, okay. So I have locals with all the content. So my file name. So the substring should be equal to 2017 1219. Yes, okay, good. Then I want 2017 in the year. So here I have incorrectly written this is a date, but I mean this is a year. Okay, then the month is 21. Why it is 21? The month, so here there is a problem. The month is not 21. So I am starting a little too late. The month should start at 4 with a length of 2. And I can put again the cursor. I want to replay this now. The month is 12, so this is good. Then the day is 19, this is good. Oh, now I have to say that I will do like int dot parse this year and do the same thing with the other parameter like this. So it will parse the day and it will parse months, and then I come back with the cursor. I want to replay this. So the red is there. Now the red is 12,990. So the way it is displayed is not necessarily good because of the culture. So let's look at here. So day is 19. Day is 19, the month is 12, and the year is okay. So this should be good. Tac, and I want to check that the expected 12/19/17 is equal to 12/19/17. And there is no problem with the hour, which is left to 0. And now I have press F5 to continue the debugging. And at the end, this date is passing. This date is passing. So I can run all the test suite and it should be successful because there is no. Okay. So good. I have. So this is the way, this is the example where you see the steps. So I start with a project, with a solution with two projects. One testing project is referencing the target project. The testing project allocates a class instance of the targeted class here. Then I start with a simple test case that I will rename just after to test the target method with a simple test. Then if it is passing, I can try different inputs. And here I am. Then after I migrate the test single input to a test case multiple input and expected output. So here, in fact, what I just forgot to do is to name correctly the method. So the requirement is, in fact, given here for a given file name, extract correct for a given file name, you should extract the dead time. So here I say when valid file name, then date is parsed. The idea behind is to say that any. So this is everyone has its own methodology. What is important is to be reliable and repeated automatically on the long term. This is my way of doing. I have targeted class underscore input when valid file name, which is the case here. Then the date is parsed. I could create another unit test with a valid invalid input. For the moment, I want to concentrate on the minimal functionality. And as I think that in my subfolder that I have copied from my smartphone, there is no invalid input, I leave for the moment like this. I want to write the minimum of the code. This is the TDD philosophy. So that it works with minimum stuff. Once I have this, what I could work on. Each file must be moved to a subfolder named this. So what I can say is for any date, create valid subfolder. Subfolder name. I can say this, so this would be trivial. So in fact, what I want here, I want a method which will generate subfolder name. Let's say this. It will have an input, a date, and an output, a string. I like to think in a system view when I start to think about a test to say what should be done, what is the input, what is the expected output. So here we are seeing I want to create a new method, generate subfolder name, that I am going to start with my unit test snippet. So one more time, I have unit test snippet with UT for unit test. UT, tab tab, method, enter. Generate subfolder name. I have here the dead time. So I will put var date is equal to new date time like this. Let's write DC 21 05 06. I am writing randomly, and this will be the input of the target method. And the rate should be equal to 2021 dash the month. And here, now Visual Studio say, this is in red because I do not know this name. Class core does not contain a definition of generate subfolder name. This is normal, this is, has not been created. We write the test first. Alt tab generate method, and you see that Visual Studio already understands that the input should be a date time. It doesn't understand yet that what should be the output. So I'm going to here like this, and I say I want to return a string, and this string rate is equal to date dot year plus this plus date dot months like this. Okay. And then I return ret with my ret snippet. Good. On here, I can say I want to test this unit test. Generate subfolder name. So I will say when valid date, then valid folder name. Execute this. Okay. And here I have an error. Expected this, but was this. So here I have just forgotten how to format correctly this. This is maybe D2. D2, I think. I'm not sure. I do this every 6 months, so every time I forget. So okay, good. Here, no. I think this should be sufficient. Okay. And I can run again everything. Okay, good. So now I have, I would say, most of the logic, hard logic, Inside my target software is maybe done. Because in fact, what I want to do is not so sophisticated. What is important is to understand the way of doing the different steps. So now I think I try to make an experiment to run this code. To run this code, I want to create a console application which will be started by hand with input parameter. The thing is that the console application must be in a specific framework and use the .NET Core, the core project. And the core project is in .NET standard. It is not possible to have a UI application or console application in .NET standard. So I have to create a new project. As I'm going to add new project, which will be a .NET Core app console application. So let's look for this class library, class library.NET framework. So I want a console application, a project for creating a command line application that can run on .NET Core. Okay, so I'm going to select this. Next, project name. This will be the Xorder. Xorder. What is the name that I have chosen? Xorder by month. I will say Xorder by month. By months. I am just thinking because the solution on the project name, when they are named the same, is always a problem. Do like this. So this will be the Xorder by month project. Location Xorder by month. Yes. Next. I am going to target the .NET Core 3.1. Okay. Create. Good. On here, my Xorder by month is writing hello world that I can start. Select it as a startup project, then run it. Hello world. Okay, so everything is working. And now what I want is, let's say I will start in no, I will input. So in fact, here what is missing is if already order one target directory. And in fact, one target directory input of the console application input of console application. I would say list of directories order each target directory included on command line. Let's say like this. So I know that here I have a list of target directories. So I'm going to start for each item in args. I will dump, say, ordering. There. are the ring holder item like this. Let's do like this, and here I will say that in my debug input debug application argument, I will say A, B, C. So it should iterate on three times on A, B, C. Ordering folder A, B, C. Good. So here I am starting the launcher. Okay. So now I will continue like this, and I'm writing the in the console app simple code that I consider to be trivial, and I consider that there is no need to unit test it. Let's say I want to XORder this directory, so I'm going to XORder directory. I will XORder this directory like this, okay. The directory is to be XORed. So what I want to do is I want to look at the file contents of this directory. So I'm going to scan for all the files of this directory. Directory dot no directory. I think this is I want directory like this is yeah okay he's proposing me using system.io but I do not remember what is to be used get files okay I want the get files of the path which is item and I like to have the same name for the parameter so the get files API is expecting a string path so I come back and this will be string path then here what is return is a array of string so this is var files is equal to this. Good. And for each var file in files, then here they will have to use some logic which has been done in my core project. Now, so you see, this is not tested. But for example, I make a for each, I make a console write line, I make a for each, I make a directory get files. This is API of Windows, there is no use to test this. So, my class core test here has. No. My class core here. Some interesting things. So I want to extract the date from the file name. I want to extract the date from the file name, and this is available in the class core class. So this will not be class core anymore. Now that the project is evolving, I have more ideas about the functionality and I can start some refactoring. And in the part of the refactoring process, there is renaming of the target class. So class core doesn't please me anymore. This is the XORder core. So I rename it, and this is Xorder core. The string hello is obsolete, I do not need it anymore. And I can rebuild. Okay, everything is successful. And you see that Visual Studio in this case understood that the file name should be renamed. If I want to be coherent, my Xorder core should impact the test, which is not anymore class core test, but Xorder core test, like this. Good. Build, rebuild, test, run all. Good. My five tests are still passing. What I forgot to do is, since the beginning, I forgot to commit, and now that I am correctly advanced, I will commit this. I stage everything by reviewing what has been done. So the class core test has been disappeared. The Xorder core test has been created. Class core has been disappeared to leave Xorder core. Okay, the solution template has been updated. Why he has updated this? Okay, core unit test, core CS proj. Okay, leave it. Program has been created. Launch settings here. This is to say I want to debug with ABC on the CS proj. Has been created. So I'm going to say console app is added and commit and push. Good. So now that has been committed, I can start from a fresh state, and every modification I will do will be tracked, and I will can easily spot them if I am creating some regression. Because now what I am doing might change the target code. Maybe, I don't know, this is the first time I do this project. Good. So, let's focus again on the program. The target program is here. Get file. Yes, I wanted to use a target class which has now, which is named Xorder Core. So Xorder Core will be used here. So I am saying that I want my core is equal to new Xorder Core. I'll tap at tab. And here you see IntelliSense is sufficiently clever to add to propose me to add the reference to the project, add reference to core. I validate and it is recognized. And I do not have here to add it manually. Oh. Core. No. This is this, Xorder by months, dependency, project, it has been added alone. So on my file, I want the core to get the date. I want to get the date of the file. Good. So our date is equal to this. Then I also want var sub beer is equal to core dot generate subfolder name. Good. With the same input file. Good. Then, no. Okay, the date is the input of this. Good. Then here I will say I want to create the subdirectory if it doesn't exist, but I think it's already doing this internally. So file, no, directory dot create directory. And this is a .NET framework method which should not be do not be to be tested. Create directory sub dir. Good. And now what I want to do is I want to move this file, file.move, like this. The input of the thing is file, and the target will be the path dot com. Path dot combine the subdir comma file. What I can do is that I do not like too much call of method so I like to introduce temporary local which will be automatically renamed to the correct parameter name, which is in fact the second parameter of the move method that I use, dest file. So move the source file to the dest file. Good. And now I can remove the blank lines, which are useless to avoid some blank in the source code. And this looks quite nice for me. I can try to do this. As I am not inputting my real folder, I can run it without any fear of corrupting any data. And let's look at what it is doing. Directory not found exception. Yes, because he says I do not know the A subfolder, which is totally normal. So what I can do in this case is me, I like to try catch all the exception, but maybe here I can catch only this exception specifically. So what I can do now, so I have seen an exception which has been triggered. So I will create some code to handle this exception. So I have a snippet for this. TRC for try catch. Like this. I will put the exception which is expected. This one, directory not found, and we'll cut all the target code here, like this, that I put inside the try catch. Okay. The log here is not known because I have started a project without installing the nlog package, but I can do it now. This should be fast. You get packager, package. I want to browse the nlog like this. This should be good, and the nlog can be used in all the projects. And now, if I come back here, log is not known, so I'm going to instantiate the log. And I have a snippet for this, so log like this. Good. There is not any more error, and I can say that I am going to test this. So ABC. Okay, and in fact, it is not outputting anything because I am logging an error, but I didn't created The logger configuration. I didn't create it. And what I can do is that I will use nlog config from one of my projects, which is there. My spec. So I should have an nlog somewhere, nlog, no, yes, I have an nlog config here. I am copying the file and I'm going to put it there, nlog config, and my console application will add an existing item, which is there, and it is a config file, and I add it, and I say I want build action none, and it should be always copied to the output directory, start rerun. Okay, now I have the error which is displayed in red. A error. Okay. Good, because in fact, in the nlog config file, I have a target console colored application with the error level with the red. I will not discuss about nlog here. You can reference, go to refer to other tutorial on this. So, what is the status currently? I think I have the valid target code. The valid code. In my test, I cannot iterate because I do not give a valid directory name. What I can do is because there is. So here, when you look at this code, there is absolutely no critical thing. So I decide to not unit test it. You can challenge this. You can say that you want to test it. Me, I do not want to test it. Because here, made class instantiation, no interest. .NET framework method, not of interest. For each method, I know what is a for each. Guided is already unit tested and there is some logic. Generate subfolder name is already tested and there is some logic. Directory create directory. .NET framework method do not be tested. Path combine, same thing. .NET target framework not to be tested. File.move, same thing. What I say now is that let's make a little try to say I want for the test I will use three files here and I will say this will be my POC because we never know, maybe I can erase all the files. I'm going to say I want to put this directory here and I'm going to say properties A, B, C. This will be one directory. Okay. And what I can do is I think there will be a little problem with the current directory. There will be a problem maybe with the current directory. Let's do it and see what is happening open folder. So I'm going to show what will happen live. So here I have my folder with the core like this. This other folder with the image file, and I'm going to move it there and run it like this to see what he's behaving. Go. So I have a breakpoint which has been triggered. I remove it. And I'm going to continue. So ordering folder, deep rock. Okay, so he understood that he should order this file. Well, I'm going to continue. And here I have a format exception. So input string was not in a correct format. Interesting. Year auto. Autos. File name. Okay. So in fact, so here this is interesting. My input was invalid. No. So here you see the issue is that the tested method has the name of the directory. So what we can say is that the caller should isolate the file name before. So here I can look at the call stack to see the caller. It is there. The caller is here. And I want to get the date of not the file containing, so let's say path of file, and here this would be string file name, and I use the path class to say I want the get file name. Like this, and here the path of file would be given there. And here I use the file name, I will get the date of the file name, I generate like this, and I pass combine the subdirectory. Path software here, so here's a little problem. Path combine subdirectory path of file create directory subdir. So here there is a little issue. Subdir is to be created, but in fact, I want to create the. So here there is the answer of the problem with the current path. Var subdir will be now equal to path subdir, which will be equal to file name. And here I'm going to duplicate this file name will be directory. Of this file. So here I'm going to use get directory name. And I would say I want the path combine of the directory of the image and add the subdirectory as a suffix. So if you do not know, path combine takes as input a directory and as a second input anything, another directory or a file, and is managing the link between the two with a backslash. If directory has a backslash, it is not doing anything. If it has not, it is suffixing a backslash, etc. So path subdirectory will be in fact created And the dest file name will be path subdirectory with only the file name. Good. And I think this look a little more clever now. Like this, and I am going to run again. So go. So it doesn't display anything. It is ready to be closed. And here I see 2019-07. And in fact, yes. So all the files are now classified. Good. What I can do to have a better... So I think the project is finished now. I will just add some debug output to understand how it is behaving. So I'm going to trace the current file name, log. So I have a debug snippet, dbg, OC. Ordering file, I would say. Ordering file like this. This would be file name. On what I can say, in fact, no. I will make a little sentence with all the what is interesting subdirectory. So here I will say moving file to what I can do is I will use string interpolation. So I want moving file to subdir. Subdir like this. Okay. So I'm going to take again all this. I move them there. I can delete this. And what I can do is open another so I would use, let's say this. Whoops. So I will use this. I copy this file. I am going to put them here. Then I'm going to take some video. Take this. On this one, okay. The image has been copied, and I'm going to run again. Whoa! So moving file, moving file to Okay. So this has been done. Good. 2110, 2112. Okay, good. So this has been done. Good. And what I can do now is I will publish this. this binary. So I can say XORder by month. There should be a .NET publish command somewhere. That I never invoked with a UI. But here for the moment I do not have the binary, correct binary. So let's go and say I will do it by hand, so XORder by month. Open folder in File Explorer, so here, 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 tac, tac, cd, tac, tac, and I want dot net publish XORder, XORder by month. Good. So, the fact that you use a publish command here, it is creating. So, here you see the JSON file, etc. Not all references have been resolved. On the publish, in the difference with the publish, normally the dependencies have been resolved. So, this is to be released, published. So, now I can go here. CD, tac, and let's be crazy, I will run it on the on this folder. Let's do this, let's be crazy. There is no backup of this, but this should work. So I am say I want to XORder. I want to XORder this. Go. XORder me this, please. Boom. Pretty nice. And now I want that you XORder me my camera. And there is. Let's make a little control. I want here, I have 460 files, 260 files. Okay, I will move it there. So I want to disorder this. So, XORder 10. Go. Good. And now, I'm going to say properties 460 files. Good. So, as I stipulated, there is no specific, on the size is correct, hein? There is no specific difficulty in the pure algorithm thing. The thing is the methodology to do it. And in addition to this tutorial, so I will leave this repo public. So you have, if you have in C Sharp, you can order your files like this and patch it if you want another scheme of classification. But I am quite happy with this. So honor has been done on the honor 9x. I can go to the honor camera, do the same thing. CLS, I want to XORder my items. Good. I am everything from 2019 to 2021. une caméra AA, I have 10. So it me, it might, so I will help him. I will help him by removing shit like this. Okay, good. Xorder. Xorder me 10. 1, 4, 5, 2 items. 18 items. And again. 1, 4, 5, 2 items. Good. Good. And do the same thing with the video. So here he will have some problem with this. But let's look at how he will behave. So Xorder me 10. And now you see is triggering an exception because here, because this is not in the correct format. So what I can do is, so this is a typical case where the input is changing and is corrupting target case. What I can do is to take this input, which is at the origin of the format exception error here. And because I'm crashing, I do not do any more things. So I will benefit for this example. I will take this thing like this. And I will patch my target test, my automated test. And this is why I say to you the focus of the unit test. So here, I didn't test anything with like move file, etc. And what I have tested is this. So here I am seeing there is a flow. There is something missing. Here I am going to duplicate this and say the targeted method should also be handling this kind of input. And here, if I am going to run this test, I have an error. Okay, so we see it there. So the error comes from the single file when I run all. So here I have an error with this file which has a different input. So what I can say is that I will handle this special case. And my idea is to say get date. Get date this. So for 2, 4, 8. You know what I see is that in fact there is this prefix which is added. So I can put some logic which looks at this kind of thing. So if my file name starts with this, then my file name will be file name sub string starting at 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7 on length. This should be my file name dot length minus 7, something like this. As I am not sure, I will put a breakpoint on this and then right click and debug it. So, my input is the file name with SLMOvid. I should go in the if. This is the case. And my file name will be truncated. So, here the V is missing. So, I started a little too late. So, I'm going to put 6 instead of 7. 6 instead of 7. And then I come back to this piece of code, re-execute it. Ah, yeah, it doesn't want to do it again because the file has been truncated. So I'm going to stop. And then re-debug. Go to the if, file name. File name is this. Then it is changed to this, okay. And then I should have so the output 20 20 8 4. So 20 20 8, and I should have 4. Okay, good. And I just have to say that. For this, I want 20 20 0 8 0 4. Good. And I can rerun the test suite. Good. And this is not executed because I think it didn't understood that it should rebuild. Test Explorer, rerun, rerun. Good. Now everything is green. My test case, just in the doubt, I run everything with this. Okay. So now everything is green again. I have corrected my patch. I'm going to republish. So I should go back to this. I'm going to publish .net publish my XorDor by Monsieur Sproc. Good. Now I move again to the folder which contains my binary, which is this CNS, and I should rerun my XorDor by Mons des photos Honor 9 vidéo. Yes, and now it should work. Go. Pam. Voilà. So, all the videos are now classified. And you can look, for example, this little boy going down the stairs. Nice. I am happy. This is good. This is good. Good chocolate. Yes. So, it's the end of this very long video. And I hope this was technically interesting for you also, and also useful to see how you can order your picture file. And I wish you a very nice, let's say, Christmas, because we are end of December 2021. I will just finish with sponsoring, with the sponsor of this video. What is the sponsor of this video? The sponsor of this video is myspector.com. Myspector.com is a website that I'm currently working on. It is written in C-sharp with the Blazor technology, and myinspector.com is a toolkit to automate web inspection. For example, here I have configured what is called a TROX. A TROX is a target HTTP page with some rules of extraction and some alert that you can set up. For example, if you want to look at the temperature of Paris, I can run the TROX. And you see that it has extracted 10. And you see name of target, it has extracted the 10 with this target. So all this can be done with the TROX configuration. If I go to the configuration tool, I can select my HTTP target here with the different protocols. Here my method, HTTP method. I use HTML XPath to extract some data in the web page. I make some comparisons, some conversion, text to number. Then I can add some checker. And I can, here in this case, I have a checker which checks if the number is less than zero. Then I have a notification to have an email. And you can do this on any kind of asset. For example, here I am inspecting the price of a mini PC. I can run it and I have configured it. So there is a little demo effect. If I reload it, it will inspect. Yes, so it has found the price 886.29, which comes from this page 886.29. And I can receive an alert if, for example, my price is below, for example, 500. And so have a look at myinspector.com. It is still under development, so everything is not functional. But it will be make me pleased if you like this video that you write me some comments and you give me some feedback about the functionality of this. This, of course, has been also written with TDD. This is me. I'm also in the camera. And that's all for this very long video. And I hope you enjoyed it. Let me in the comments what you think. Goodbye.